जय हिंद, नमस्ते, हेलो. दिस इज अनिमेश जैन फ्रॉम द मेवाड़ यूनिवर्सिटी बैच ऑफ 2010-2014. आई वॉज एनरोल्ड इन द फैकल्टी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग इन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड आई हैव कंप्लीटेड माय बीटेक इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशंस. लेट मी एट द आउटसेट एक्सटेंड माय बेस्ट विशेस टू द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ होम आई हैव बीन अ प्राउड एलुमनाई. एंड आई ऑल्सो वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस माय ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू एज वी ऑल आर फाइटिंग विद द पैंडेमिक COVID-19, and this is a tough time we are all going through. In this time, I was asked by university to share my experience so that they can utilize this message and send it across to the world and to know how Mewa University has been doing so far in its existence. So I'm going to share my experience with all of you, and don't consider this as my feedback, because feedback is something of which people can be critical of. But this is more of a real-time experience which I have had with my duration of 4 years at Mewar University. So I'll divide my experience into four pieces. Firstly, I'll talk about the academics, which will be more about the studies part and the learning journey at Mewar University. Secondly, I'll talk about the infrastructure and the resources at Mewar University. Then I'll be talking about the trainings and placements. And lastly, I'll cover the most fascinating part which most of the students feel, it's the co-curricular and the extracurricular activities at campus. So let me first talk about the academics part. When I joined Mewar University in 2010, I was very much surprised by seeing those huge labs and workshops into their campuses. And my idea of, like anyone else, I went to Kota, and my idea of engineering was we have to go to some great campuses, and then I ended up with Mewar University. So it was always inspiring to see when faculties used to come from various IITs and NITs and they used to teach us. And then what clicked me was the involvement of these faculties into various research projects, and they were all involved in writing white papers and doing some sorts of new work in the field of science and technology. And I also got an opportunity to work with some faculties who were working on some projects from DST. So that way I felt that I'm in the right hands as far as my academics was concerned, and they tried to maintain that level of knowledge resources for the entire course of 4 years, and I hope the same was continued even when I passed out, because my juniors have shared the similar kind of experience. So as far as the learning resources and the knowledge resources were concerned, there were in-house faculties, there were visiting faculties who used to come for dedicated specific subject to bring that bridge into the industry and academia. And of course, the in-house faculties was always there, who were one of the best brains in the country. The next I'll talk about is the infrastructure. As I mentioned, that I was already fascinated when I saw those huge workshops and labs, and when I started actually working in those for my practical exams and other things, it was good to learn that those labs were not just confined to conduct the practical labs. They were the technicians there, and the faculties there, the professors there were actually utilizing those labs for their research purposes. And it was open for us that if we want to do some projects, if we want to learn something new and do a practical experiment for that, we can even do that. And I realized it when we participated in certain tech fest, and when we conducted our own tech fest, how to leverage those resources, those labs and technologies. I also want to mention that most of the labs are equipped with the best of learning resources, which are recommended by the industries, and some of those resources which the industry actually uses. So kudos to the university for having one of the best lab setup and the workshop setup in the remotest of location in Rajasthan. And when you're talking about the infrastructure and the resources, I am anyone who visits the campus is left into awe. And this is because it is surrounded with the Aravalli ranges. It's located into a remote location. But when you see those huge buildings and then surrounded by the greenery and the kind of infrastructure they maintain, it shows that they are committed to what they are offering. They are committed to offering you knowledge. Then when they say knowledge to wisdom, they have got all those resources which delivers you knowledge and it gives you certain wisdom. So they are committed to it, and their infrastructure is a standing example there of their commitment. And when they are so much committed on their knowledge resources, on their learning resources, that should, the good way to testify those resources is the kind of trainings and placements they have to offer. So I was also part of the trainings and placement cell as a student coordinator when I was in my third year. And it was good to learn that they are very well connected with the with most of the manufacturing units within the region and in Rajasthan and even in the NCR belt. And they have great connects and they bring many great companies from the IT sector and many MNCs on board for the campus recruitment. And many of my friends also have, had got placed in that. During my internship for the 6 months, I was working on some of the sites of Tata Communications in Gurgaon. And most of the friends, they were also part of some of the great organizations in India. One of the great things about the academics and the courses which are offered at Mewar University are those 6 months internship or training where you actually go and work hands-on onto what industry is requiring. And that makes you fit to be absorbed directly by the industry where you have completed your 6 months course. So that is one unique part about the courses which were about our course of engineering which was offered to us. And lastly, I would like to also talk about the extracurricular activities which are offered. So we were one of those initial batches of the university, so we started with we started proposing to the university to start student clubs, and they allowed us. We constituted few of the clubs there, and we conducted certain activities. And seeing the results, the university also said that they would like to continue those clubs even once we pass out from there. I'm happy to share with you that during my recent visit last year, I saw some of those clubs still exist, and the existing students still try to leverage those clubs to conduct their activities. So that's one great thing. And in terms of the extracurricular and co-curricular activities, the university believes in your holistic growth, what generally the industry calls it 360 degree learning environment. So be it sports, be it your cultural activities, be it arts or participation into external events, all of that is allowed and all of that is hugely encouraged. I have been myself to many of the national events. We did conduct many of the events and where we saw participation from institutes of great repute. Our batch was also fortunate where we got to conduct some of the international to be part of some of the international conferences and workshops which are conducted by some of the resources who are internationally recognized. So all that is there, and I'm confident the university is still doing all of that because it adds more value to whatever your academics are doing. These add-on factors from external world, it does a reality test for the students who are already learning, and it is also a good way to know how things are externally happening and are we in sync with that. So that way I feel institute is well prepared for it and they are taking necessary actions and they bridge that academia industry gap which certain times is called out by many corporates. So in our time we had experienced all of this, and I am very sure the university is still taking care of all of these things, and they would have actually improved some of those resources over a period of time based on the current requirement in the world of academics. With that said, I would like to again express my thankfulness to the university and gratitude to the university for giving me this opportunity of sharing my experience. And I wish my heartfelt congratulations to all the upcoming batches in Mewar University. Thank you so much.